36 days to the NFL season, and so we have a packed show. Starting first off with Justin Houston, the veteran defensive end who's been in the league for a long time, has signed with the Baltimore Ravens. This is a great move on the Ravens' part because they desperately need a defensive end that has veteran leadership skills, who shows he's still got something left in the tank. They lost Matthew Judon this past offseason, and they haven't done anything really to it. Bringing in Justin Houston on a cheap one-year deal is a great move. It's a great move by their organization. You can get a great veteran who can showcase that he can lead by example. The New York Giants had decided to release Kelvin Benjamin over the fact that he was overweight and had a confrontation with head coach Joe Judge and Dave Gettleman. Now, I'm not an expert on these sort of things, but I don't think yelling at your employer is going to do much. Kelvin Benjamin later went and said, Joe Judge does not know what he's doing, which we've heard a lot about former Belichick assistants, but this is a very interesting one because Joe Judge coached under Bill Belichick, but before that he coached under Bill Belichick's defensive coordinator when he was in Cleveland in the mid to late 90s, and that was Nick Saban. So he coached under Nick Saban and Bill Belichick. That's a great position to be in. But Kelvin Benjamin doesn't believe that he knows what he's doing. And supposed reason was they wanted him down to get to this weight, which I believe was 250, and he was at 260 or 268, something like that. Doesn't sound awful, but it doesn't look good, according to if you're looking at the big picture of this, it doesn't look good for Kelvin Benjamin to ever get back in the league if he's going to act that kind of way to a coach. The Browns gave Nick Chubb a 3-year, $36.6 million contract. And that's a big contract, suggesting that it was just a somewhat of a good extension, a piece that you need to bring back. And Nick Chubb is one of those guys that you do need to bring back. Now, the guarantees are unclear. They're roughly between $28 million and $30 million. So it's around that point. Devontae Freeman signs with the Saints on a cheap one-year deal. And why not bring another guy in? Maybe there'll be a camp battle. You get the best of between Freeman, Murray, and Kamara. If Kamara's even in that competition, it might be only Murray and Freeman. The Colts had signed quarterback, ex-Packer Brett Hundley, after news that Carson Wentz would be out indefinitely, which we'll get to later in the show, but he was out indefinitely depending on if he had surgery or not, which we'll get to in a few minutes from now. The Vikings' third-year wide receiver, if I pronounce this wrong, I'm sorry, Olabisi Johnson, tore his ACL in practice, which it's sad in a lot of ways because these players, they don't get to play a whole lot, especially when you're a guy that is on the lower half of the roster and you're just trying to make a team. And when you have a player like Olabisi Johnson, you hope he does well, but you don't know if he can't be on the field. And so that could put him in a position where he might get cut and he doesn't want to be in that position. And it's a shame that that happens that way. And that stinks. But it's part of the NFL. It's just the way it goes. Nick Sirianni is impressed by Jalen Hurts, in which who isn't? Like he has, everyone said that Jalen Hurts was terrible. No, Jalen Hurts isn't terrible. Jalen Hurts has promise. The problem is he only played four games in a position in which he would have been 2-2, but then the getting taken out of the Washington game later in the last game of the season. So it you understand why he is impressive. But also, you have Joe Flacco. Okay, there is not anyone else that is really going to be like, oh, well, he'll be fine. Joe Flacco's going to take the job. No, it's just not going to happen. Hurts is gifted. It just matters if he can showcase that he's gifted. Sirianni also said he was not concerned with Jalen Reagor, who has a personal issue and he didn't test very well.